Okay, guys, I am back after a while. I won my custody case. I got my son back. Okay, everything's looking good. I got a spot rented out, an RV spot, making some money finally. And then another neighbor wants to be complaining, think, you know, because they don't like Americans living free on private property. You know what I'm saying? They don't like us. They don't like poor people. They don't. So he complained and against their codes or whatever. So you can't have an RV. So this guy come over here and said, "Oh, we find you a probable cause or whatever over here." So you know, a probable cause of nothing. So as far as I'm concerned, if you check in the description, I'm gonna have my two letters. One letter. It's gonna be affidavit sent, and just two pages, and then two pages of the exhibits, and exhibit appendix. So I'm going to put that into the description below, redacted with some private information taken out, and hopefully we'll see what happens. You know, if I'm a free American living off private property, or am I a corporate slave? You know, because I'm fine either way, right? I don't care. I want it in writing. If you see right in the description, you see what I've been talking about, especially with all the protections we have. Yeah, I've been hooting and hollering about Clause 17, Section 8, you know, whatever it was. Article 1, Section 8, Clause 17, I can't find it anywhere. So I don't know what the hell I was talking about. But I did find a lot of other laws that I'm able to use. Surpus delicti, it's no victim, no injured party, no crime. There's case law I cited. Lots of case laws. There's no injured party. Vague contract agreements. There's voidness of vagueness I found, where it says, you know, basically we're not part of that. You know, there's the 13th Amendment of involuntary certitude. You know, like, you can't force you into contracts. We got to be like, you know, volunteering into them. So there's more to it. The 14th Amendment of due process, where you get a jury, you know, you get to right to face your accuser, all that stuff. The 5th Amendment, 6th Amendment to defend yourself, of course. You can't do any of that unless you defend yourself under the 6th Amendment. I cited all this stuff in there. I also got my my response. This is my my letter to them. I'm going to be sending it to them. And then the backup, of course, is going to be an email. So it's going to stay in there that it's going to send in my email. As soon as I get confirmation that this was delivered, a whole context of the email will be sent, so they can't say they don't know what they got. This is all set up straight. I got information and evidence I used that I did contact code, you know, compliance. We were working together, but it's pretty much they're the public servant. We're the person, you know, they're making me do their job and pay for it. You know, I mean, I understand I want to sell the property, this and that. It's for that reason, you have to acquire permits. So I'm like, yeah, okay, one day I want to sell the property, acquire these permits. That's the only reason why I'm going, you know, going to volunteer. But, well, like I said, if you go into description, you will read a lot of the my defense here, and we'll see what's up. We'll see, because like I said before, if I'm a letter written down, if I'm a slave or I'm a corporate person, because if I'm free under the Constitution, they got to leave me alone, right? Okay. If I'm not free under the Constitution, I'm a corporate slave, then what's up? Then slaves don't own property, right? So like I said, it's their property. This is their problem. There's no public endangerment. I proved that. I said I wrote them, tell them to prove to me what kind of endangerment you're talking about. Crickets. So I use that again as evidence, and I even cited to them real quick. You know, you guys can reply back. You'll read the description of what I wrote. You'll see if you guys can reply back and show exactly how we're wrong and what we're talking about here. You know, and then I hope ultimately this could be used. You know, so we can get our fucking rights back here. Everybody's getting treated like they're a goddamn slave on this land. This neighbor, these people want to act like, again, I'm part of these contracts. And no, I am a person under the Bill of Rights. You understand? If you read the Ninth Amendment. The Ninth Amendment says that you can't be discouraging or something about everybody has to be the rights. If some people are right over here, use the, you know, you can't just discriminately say, now it doesn't apply to me if it applies to them. Then the law applies equal protection. I think it's also the 14th Amendment. But like I said, it's a lot to go through. It's a lot to remember, you know. But pretty much, like I said, I come into this thing as care of. So again, I'm a person, you don't say that your legal name, you know. So it's pretty much, you'll see, as care of. You know, and then we go into the probable cause business right there. And then pretty much, even if there is probable cause or isn't probable cause, which I stand firmly that the people that are just living life free under the Constitution, you know, on private property, minding their own business, is not probable cause of anything, right? I mean, it's probable cause of against them because they don't like freedom. But is freedom a fucking crime? You know, straight up, I'm like, yo, is purchasing property a fucking crime? You know what I'm saying? So we're going to find out, huh? If I'm a corporate slave, let it be known I'm a corporate slave, because then, like I said, it's their property. Right, promissory note, whatever they got to do. This is your fucking property anyways. Do what you're going to do. I had it up to here with these fucking people. I got custody back. Say, I want to put Section 8. Give me a fucking home to go. I'm trying to live my life, you know, do for myself. I got solar panels, right? I'm saying I got a bunch of well, septic, sewer, all that going on. And they're going to come over here and say, like, oh, climate change or whatever the fuck these niggas trying to say. Like, oh, we can't have people living in an RV or something. I think they classified it as in a summons I received. It says something about biohazard or some shit. Like, I look around, there's people got RVs all over the fucking place. You can tell me that's the probable cause or something. I mean, this could be a kangaroo, but we'll see. But I mean, like I said, the probable cause or no probable cause, the violations of my of our supposed protected civil rights is going to be put to test right now. So the court hearing is for January 2nd, right? Which obviously, like I said, I ain't going to that. I want to be subpoenaed, and I want to be pointed out exactly the law they have to get me to go to court, because like I pointed out, and if you see it, I point out in there that they don't meet any requirements to get me to go do anything. I don't have to say anything. I don't have to answer any questions. I have the right not to, incriminate myself. You know what I'm saying? So it's all written in clear as crystal, okay? Right, black and white. So I'm going to be uploading that, and then we'll see the outcome. I'll be back to see when I get subpoenaed, if I don't get subpoenaed within a month or two, or what's up, you know. And then when the court hearing happens, I'll obviously be, you know, I'll document that. Maybe I'll have a court recorder, most likely. I'm going to have a court recorder in there so they can't be pulling some nothing. And then ultimately, if I do again have to go to court again, I'm going to pretty much just use what I sent. I won't have to say much of anything. I'm just going to either for the record, cite what I sent, my affidavit, or, again, I want this case to be dismissed, obviously, you know? If I sign nothing, I need a lawyer first, need some time before I go over signing, engaging any contracts, okay? And we'll see if they try arresting me, because, again, I'm not sure. I haven't made a video in a while, so you guys don't realize, like, I did win custody back, but it was a violent and very costly process. I'm actually under probation right now, still for the next 6 months. I didn't do anything wrong. I made a phone call. You know, supposedly making a phone call is bad. You know, so it is what it is. I don't know if they're going to try using that against me somehow, because they totally can, to say that's probable cause. But that's near. I'm on welfare too, so they can claim that to say probable cause or whatever. Or like I said, in the letter, I mean, perfectly clear, child endangerment, CPS, they come, I don't care. I got no child endangerment going on over here. I am firmly not trying to hide anything. And this is the second time people try blackmailing you to things that when you're free, you try to help people, and then the first thing they go, oh, well, you have a right to travel, right? No, that's illegal. I'm going to get you in trouble. We need to just explain to them the right to travel and all this shit. You know, then no buying car insurance, bull fucking shit. Where's the law say you got to buy car insurance? That's going to be the next fight that I'm probably going to document. When I do go to try to get car insurance and then watch them refuse to give me car insurance. I mean, I'm sorry, not car insurance. Registrate my car and say they're going to refuse to give me my registration because I'm not going to get car insurance. I'll say, you get car insurance. Your fucking car, right? It's not my car. It's your car. If you got to tell me all of this, it's not my property. It's fucking your property. You know, so that's why I advocate. You get a brand new car off the lot. You don't take it to the DMV, you know. Then they can't tow your car or do anything. Now you want to try your search to travel and all this crap? Again, you have a car that's been registered at the DMV. You'll see who owns that car real quick when you try asserting your rights. So some people are able to get away with it. They know who they are. They sue them. They're right people. They got some money. Okay, but you know, for people like us, you know, it's going to take a lot of time. If you're in a big city, you're not going to get recognized. You'll be in fucking court all the time. I just recommend you just get a trailer or something and you just use that sticker, you know, and then just... drive real careful. That's all I'm saying, you know. But I still wouldn't register the car, whoever you got it from. I would not register it. Just say like you bought the car. It seems to work. It seems to pretty much work for me. I just bought the car, you know. Just play stupid because it's a lot easier to go along with it. Ultimately, it's probably gonna go to where it's gonna go. Like I said, but hopefully I'll have a car at that time that's not registered with the DMV, and I'm not gonna give a fuck. Just start a right to travel, no license plate, no nothing. There's videos out there already, people proving it, showing they're making $250,000 a bankrupt corporation, because that's what they are. They're a bankrupt corporation posing as a constitutional government. Now, I should have said something like that in the letter, but if you read what I wrote, I'm going to redact some of it. It's going to be in the description. You know, Maybe you could point out some errors that I made or not, or if somebody did this before, that's great. I cited case law. I got all the amendments in there, the 14th, the 13th, the 9th, the 6th, the 5th, the 4th. Those are all the ones that I pretty much got in there. And like I said, we'll see what happens. I look forward to seeing your comments. I'm still alive, everybody, for everybody wondering. And keeping up the good fight. Grumbles out. Peace out. Till next time.